everyone. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. Last night at 7:42 p.m. there in South Carolina, there was a magnitude 4.2 earthquake. It was shallow, about 2.7 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are from sea level. 56 people said they felt this earthquake. USGS originally said it was a magnitude 3.1, and they revised it to a 2.4. Here's location of some of the felt reports. We got up north here, which was Boone. We also got Thomasville, closer to the earthquake. Intensity level 4, Pageland. Let's see. All the way down to Charleston. Intensity level 3. Let's see. Greenville. Is there anything else? No, that's it. So intensity level 4 would have meant that to those people in that area, it felt like a magnitude 3, maybe a 3.5. Felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few. At night, some may have been woken up. Dishes, windows, and doors were rattling. Autos rocked noticeably. This would have been Friday night. Let me bring it out and show you what's going on here. Yeah, like I said, it was a 3.1 that they revised it to a 2.4. Here we got the East Piedmont Fault. And it'll come out a little bit farther. All this area east of the Piedmont Fault used to be under the ocean. And because of tectonic collision, the opening of the Atlantic Ocean, and with the weakening of the Earth's magnetic field, with the coming magnetic pole flip, we're going to see more and more earthquakes like this. I'll give you a link to this down below. It says South Carolina earthquakes result from the reactivation of ancient geological structures associated with much older tectonic events, such as the building of the Appalachian Mountains and the rifting that opened the Atlantic Ocean. Here's an image of the Edisto River Basin there in South Carolina. All this was coastal plain until the oceans dropped. They were about 192 feet higher than what they are now. And because of the dropping of the ocean and uplift, you can see this is a great area that now is exposed. In the pink is the Edisto Basin. So here's the location of the 3.1 revised to a 2.4. Down here we have Myrtle Beach. Yeah, that's where the spy balloon landed, crashed, got shot down. The reason they shot the equipment and not the balloon itself is the missile that they used needs to have impact on something hard before it would explode. So the payload was what they ended up hitting and probably destroying a lot of the equipment that China had on there. Just firing a missile through the balloon would not have brought it down. And past events where they riddled these balloons full of air, it wasn't enough to bring them down. It wasn't enough holes. Maybe they should consider a shotgun. A shotgun might work pretty good. So this is not far from that other earthquake swarm that they were having, and they claimed it was caused by water seeping into the ground from the watery river. We got some major, and I mean major, devastating events coming as these earth changes escalate more and more. Also yesterday, there was a magnitude 1.9 earthquake near Casey, South Carolina. 5 people said they felt that. That would have been at 3:35 p.m. yesterday. So that would have been about 3 miles below sea level. They gave it an intensity level of 3, which means it would have felt like maybe a passing truck. Was felt noticeably indoors, but not always recognized as an earthquake. Standing autos rock slightly. looks like the felt reports came from Red Bank in Colombia. So going back to Google Earth, let's go to the location of that earthquake. Right down there. Doesn't look like a lot of houses. Mostly businesses, it looks like. There's a hatchery. I bet you the chickens were all acting up down there. And an electric motor company, it says, I guess. Okay, let's bring this out. Yeah, see, there's that Eastern Piedmont fault system again. And let's come out a little bit farther. Yeah, see, this was all under the ocean at one time. Not far from the 3.1, close to it. And again, there's Myrtle Beach. Here it talks about the Piedmont fault system. The rock down underneath there has not been studied a lot. It talks about the Gardner-Edisto fault that extends from the Savannah River to at least the mouth of St. Helena Sound and is seismically active. And that's that area drawn out in red. But I wanted to come down here about the opening of the Atlantic Ocean. The opening of the Atlantic Ocean caused igneous activity that increased over the future continental margin of South Carolina. The coastal plain of South Carolina was submerged from the late Jurassic period into the middle Eocene episode until sea levels began to fluctuate. Alternating rise and fall in sea level formed the characteristics substrate of the ACE basin. As sea levels increased, marine sediment were deposited and the sea levels fell. Marine barrier, back barrier, marsh, and fluvial sediments were deposited over the eroded remains or remnants of the previous transgressive sequence. And then because of deposits, it formed the secondary barrier islands. Regional studies indicate that this zone of uplift is approximately 200 kilometers long and 15 kilometers wide. The zone of uplift appeared to have deflected the Edisto River. The South Fork Edisto River flows southeast out of Saluda County and parts of its confluence with the North Fork Edisto River. The Edisto River continues to flow in a nearly straight line southeast until it reaches the northwestern or northwest margin of the zone of uplift. At this locality, the Edisto River is deflected abruptly to the south into the ACE basin. If the zone of uplift were not present, the Edisto River would connect with the Ashley River and flow into Charleston Harbor. So again, up over here, we got the 3.1. There's the 2.3. Here we have the Edisto River. And this is the area of Charleston. Let me zoom in a little bit. I thought that was pretty interesting. You can hardly see it. It's such a thin, small river, the way it looks here on Google Maps. And let's follow it. Going east. And you can see it curves down, and that's because of the uplift. Let's see, where does it come out at? Let's see here. Yeah, I'll bring it out a little bit. Going down, 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 down. That is one long river. Okay, down here by Seabrook Island and Edisto Island. And then Charleston, it would have originally probably come out over here if it wasn't for the uplift. So I hope you enjoyed that little bit of geology. Did you feel any of these earthquakes? If so, please put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Make sure you still subscribe, because YouTube loves to unsubscribe people. Thank you again. Please stay safe. Always be prepared for a disaster. Could have flooding. Could have landslides. Chemical explosions like what happened there in Ohio. Tornadoes and earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. You just don't know what will happen. Please stay safe, be prepared, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.